Honestly, I'm getting kind of bored with the technology that I'm working with. Have you ever just started typing out some code and saw that other developers on the internet are having way more fun than you? This is a daily struggle, and I'm seeing way too many programmers on the internet having the time of their life debugging, testing, whatever it is. Today, I'm gonna do some research and tell you all of the technologies that I want to learn this year. But first, let's talk about what I know. Funny enough, when I used to be a blogger boy back in 2019, I wrote an article called Tech I Want to Learn in 2020. I will have write more about this soon. But for now, good job, Lewis. No wonder no one read your articles back in the day. Since I started my programming career, I've primarily focused on the web. That means I was using JavaScript and PHP when I first started. As of 2019, I was using Python and using the Django framework for basically anything in the backend. In my list, I listed off Nginx, Webpack, Linux, Flask, CSS NJS, Nest.js, TypeScript, Svelte, Postgres. Out of all those, I actually ended up learning most of them, apart from like Nest.js and Webpack. And thank God for that. I did learn C and Java in school, but I never use them anymore and I forgot how to do anything with them. So if I were to analyze everything I'm doing on a day-to-day basis, which by the way, if you haven't seen my day in the life video, go check that out. I use Python, TypeScript, Postgres, Docker, Flask, Svelte or React, AWS Cloud. Okay, let's start. I mean, at this point, we're continuously discussing something that has been discussed extensively online for the last couple of months. The advent of AI, specifically ChatGPT, BingGPT, and Stable Diffusion has led to a rapidly growing market in the field of AI. However, for programmers, this has been something that's extremely common for like the last 5 years. Open source software like TensorFlow has been around for a very long time, but only now has AI become much easier to develop at a rapid pace and ready to integrate within your existing applications. When all this was coming up, I thought it was a huge undertaking to learn TensorFlow, machine learning, and that huge entire industry just to make something that we are now able to plug into today. Companies like Hugging Face is making it easy to use pre-existing models to fine-tune towards your needs. Although this isn't true learning of AI and more so just importing it into the application, it serves as a good stepping stone to go backwards into learning into machine learning. Thanks to today's sponsor, Sneak, you can build your application fast and with the ease of mind that you're keeping your application secure for your users. Sneak scans your code and your dependencies for your applications against its massive vulnerability database to keep your app secure at every moment. Setup is extremely easy as Sneak can integrate with your IDE, repository, or CI/CD pipeline so that you don't accidentally push that scary code to production. I've been using Sneak in my GitHub repositories to privately alert me and submit a pull request when a known vulnerability is found in one of my dependencies. Even better, it works with Docker images too, so you can find vulnerabilities in every area of the tech stack. Click the link in the description to find out why top companies like AWS, Google, Twilio, and more are using Sneak to secure their infrastructure. I mean, they're smart cookies, so I would trust them. I admit, I'm jumping on the Rust hype train. If you don't know what Rust is, which if you don't, do you live under a rock? Are you okay? It's a programming language focused on great developer experience. It features on safety and correctness while having insane performance that can match low-level languages like C or C++. Every single year, the Stack Overflow Developer Survey always lists Rust as the number one programming language that is most loved by developers. When I learned TypeScript a while ago, it made me realize that it was really necessary in my code base to become truly more productive, even if that meant more typing. Funny enough, what got me into this Rust hype train is the Primogen's video about Rust for TypeScript developers. You should absolutely check out that video. It's seriously incredible. But how do I get that mustache? Ah, Linux. I'm so intimidated by you at every single level. However, this is the year where I would love to change my primary workstation to Linux. So why Linux? Well, it's completely customizable and I truly stand behind the message that Linux and open source stands behind. Right now I'm using a Mac and despite there being some things I'm a fan of, I do feel like the latest updates that keep happening is making it much worse. Of course, since I'm doing a lot of video and creative work, as you're seeing right now. I would like to keep these setups, but I think it would be a great challenge to fully move over to Linux. I am familiar with Linux on the server. Just changing over to the desktop will be an adjustment. I've been a gamer my entire life, so obviously something I wanna do is make a video game. Seems pretty easy though, right? Well, it's not whatsoever. I did a couple of Unity tutorials about a year ago, and since I have an understanding of programming, it wasn't necessarily the programming itself that was hard, but more so how to make a, well, good game. Turns out it's more than just programming. Who would have known? I have a video plan coming soon about me building a video game in a very short amount of time that I'm excited to start production on. In the meantime, something I gotta get started on quick is 3D softwares like Blender or Cinema 4D and the C# programming language. Make sure you subscribe so you can see when that video comes out. Very excited to show it to you guys. So a huge deal for me back in the day was finally learning React. If you understand React or if you've been too intimidated, then you know that it's a huge learning curve trying to understand this ecosystem. The funny thing is that once you learn it, you think, I can never go back to original JavaScript. For those who don't know, React is a front-end JavaScript library used to create user interfaces. What makes it much different is the way you do things in JSX, which are like a combination of JavaScript and HTML. When you use it for a long time, you get stuck in a mentality that it is for sure what you need. Svelte's approach is that it's a compiler instead of using the virtual DOM like React. So you get insane performance boosts. What I like the most though is the developer experience. You still have the component like structure, but it's more like basic HTML with text similar to something of PHP or Liquid if you've ever used that. I've been dabbling with Svelte and my new startup that I have linked down below there. Definitely check it out and join the waitlist if you can. So far, I'm really liking it and it's much better than React. Let me know if you want me to do a live stream on Svelte. I am a programmer. I'm definitely not an IT person. So the concept of advanced IT infrastructure, things like networking, provisioning, reverse proxies, etc., is a little bit intimidating. Like, what on earth is a CIDR block? CIDR block? What is that? For me to truly understand how the cloud really works, I need to first dabble in some IT professionalism. The cloud is something that everyone would need to learn at some point, but for me, I would like to understand what each individual component would need in order to be fully scalable. The amount of times I had to fix something when it went down, it's a little embarrassing. I've worked with AWS in the past and I have been using them for so many years, so perhaps this year, I'll also look into getting an AWS Solutions Architect certificate. However, this isn't my biggest priority, considering that I already kind of know the cloud, I just want to get a little bit better with it. Okay, the Raspberry Pi is run on a version of Linux, so it's not the unit itself I want to learn, but more so the aspects of what comes with a Raspberry Pi, like robotics, IoT, etc. I bought one of these about a month ago, sadly for a price I'm too humiliated to share. However, I have some really exciting videos I want to make with some ideas similar to my Reddit bot video. I also own an Arduino somewhere around here, like maybe in this vault right here. Funny story is that one of my first videos on my channel was a solution to an online video course I was doing about the Arduino. It's a bit cringe, but people liked it. Raspberry Pis are these little microcomputers used to automate different things, especially in the IoT sector. You connect them to things like microcontrollers, mini webcams, sound systems, etc. And you can control it all using the Raspberry Pi, which has a version of Linux inside that you can control using Python or really any programming language. I have some really cool stuff coming out about the Raspberry Pi on this channel, so make sure you subscribe so you can catch that when I post it. I also hope the supply issues stop soon with them because right now they're way too expensive. Throughout my coding career, deployments have been pretty messy. I can't really blame anyone but myself though, because I'm the one constantly choosing to put it off until it needs to be done. The world of DevOps is a philosophy aimed to create a cycle of seamless integration from your local machines to your production machines and everything in between. It's mostly shown as an infinity loop that kind of looks like this. Yep, that's how they work, Lewis. You can really go into crazy detail about this, so if you want to see a full video, let me know. But as a professional software developer, I would love to be able to have confidence in the ability to deploy my code every single time. So with continuous integration and continuous delivery pipelines to help me take my project from the repository to the server, or the continuous feedback loop of hearing customers, I need a new philosophy behind it. One of my favorite open source projects is 90 Days of DevOps by Michael Cade, where he documents a roadmap of every single thing he learns, including using Git effectively, containers, infrastructure as code, and more. If you want to learn as well, it's an absolute must, and it's free and open source, so shout out to him. So it's an ambitious year for me, for sure. I think at this rate, I would have to learn each of these every single month of the year, which doesn't seem doable when I have a full-time job as well as doing this YouTube thing. What technologies are you learning this year? Let me know in the comments below. Peace out, coders.